Well, hello there, my abundant healers. Have you ever heard the expression, a penny saved is a penny earned, money is the root of all evil, no pain, no gain, work hard, play hard, money doesn't grow on trees? Well, you might think that these expressions are innocuous, or you might think that they make sense. But today we are going to dispel these raggedy old money myths so that you can start calling in consistent, high-paying clients with ease. And so this video is in promotion of a 30-day video challenge that I am doing to promote my online signature course, The Abundant Healer, 90 Days to Scale Your Practice Online, which is a one-stop shop that helps therapists, coaches, and healers call in the kinds of clients, cash flow, and clout that they want, all without having to spend a bunch of money on experts and gurus or piecemeal a bunch of different programs together, even if they have never written a lesson or made a dollar online. And so I am super happy to be popping on here doing this video challenge with you. And we're gonna debunk these raggedy old money myths today. So at the foundation of my brand mission is really an adherence to what I call spiritual wealth, which is to say that money is energy expressed in paper form. So before you can implement the what I call physical apparatuses, which is technology and marketing strategies, to call in the clients and cash flow that you want, you have to get your emotional vibe in alignment with what I consider to be your soul's purpose. So let's take a closer look at how your energy might manifest these popular money myths out there. So first, a penny saved is a penny earned. Well, you can imagine that someone saying this would have root energy that is contracted and withholding or kind of rigid. Now, when I say root energy, I'm talking about the root chakra. And the root chakra is associated with basic security needs. Roof over your head, food on the table, money in the bank, but it also relates to body, the relationship to your body. Are you comfortable in your body? Are you secure within yourself? So someone who doesn't have root energy that is flowing, that is balanced, that has a nice flexibility to it, a penny saved is a penny earned. You can imagine like someone kind of miserly holding on to all of their coins and their dollars, and there's a fear of something being taken away. So it doesn't come from an abundant mindset. It actually comes from a scarcity mindset. There's only so much in the world, and you have to section off your little corner of it and defend it at all costs, because if you were to have that taken away, then you would feel lacking. So another one, money is the root of all evil. Well, this type of person tends to use moral justifications for their own fears about stepping into their own power and assuming personal authority, because they prefer to remain contracted and victimized. And usually that's because sometimes being in the victim role actually affords you some power. I call it the martyred syndrome. But if you are always at a disadvantage, then you can use that disadvantage to make other people feel guilty or to make yourself out to be the martyr. Okay, and that carries a certain kind of emotional weight and clout with it as well. So we start throwing moral platitudes out there. That is when we start to get in trouble with thinking about money as being an expression of deservedness. Okay, I'll do another video about that more in depth. Now, another one of these is no pain, no gain. And similarly, work hard, play hard. Now, these myths tend to resonate with a person who also struggles with deservedness and worthiness. So they're often overworked, exhausting themselves beyond what is necessary, or let's be honest, healthy, and then they boomerang into playing hard, which is only a form of escapism at that point. Sometimes that could even be in the form of addictions, which would be another indicator of root chakra imbalances. Okay. And so we can see these myths are really more born of either a contracted or overtaxed energy patterning in the body and in our psyches. So these myths evolve out of what I described before as a scarcity attitude, and that suggests that wealth and abundance can only be achieved through misery and a pound of flesh. And here's one more. Money doesn't grow on trees. Well, Grant Cardone, who is a business consultant and author of the 10X rule, says that money comes from a cotton bush, actually. But seriously, the concept that money is scarce is just not true. There's a shortage of people going for money with courage and the right attitude. So our attitudes surrounding money are usually picked up from our parents, our family, and our friends, and it's not always just what our parents say, but it's also what they do. We observe and we witness as children a significant, what we observe and witness as children has a significant impact on our money myths, Okay. So here are 11 questions that you can ask yourself to start digging into your own money myths. So think about your parents and how you grew up as a child. Did your parents clip coupons every Saturday? Did they always buy the generic brand? Did they give you hand-me-downs to wear? Did they say that you couldn't afford something when you knew that they could? Did they hold money over your head to make you do whatever they said? Did they make huge investments with the expectation that you would assume responsibility for them when you got older? Did they spend money like they had it when they really didn't? Did they always rely on other family members to bail them out? Did they refuse to ask for help even when they did really need it? Or perhaps they tried to buy your love with gifts, or perhaps they stole from your sock drawer, or maybe you would help them out. Maybe you helped them out 97% of the way, and then all they do is complain about the 3% that you didn't give. So this is really not to blame our parents or accuse them of anything. You know, our parents usually do the best that they could with what they had. But it's really important to name and acknowledge what you might have adopted by osmosis so that you can make a conscious choice about how much you want their money myths to limit your beliefs about what is possible for your financial abundance in this lifetime. So I would love it if you would let me know in the comments below your responses to any of these questions. What were some of the money myths and the behaviors that you witnessed in your upbringing, and how have those evolved into the myths that you carry now about your ability to make money and to really fully step into your financial and spiritual abundance? Because again, this is all about spiritual wealth. And if you are a therapist, coach, and/or healer, and you're interested in building a profitable online platform that attracts those high-paying, consistent clients, all while adding flexibility to your schedule, increasing your financial freedom, and honoring your soul purpose, then I also invite you to check out the link to a free training in the comment of this video. You are going to walk away with a downloadable PDF of my best-selling funnel framework and online marketing strategy that has generated up to $10,000 per month in online revenue. So if you are ready to scale your practice online while opening up to more flexibility and financial freedom, all without having to resort to salesy gimmicks or succumbing to tech overwhelm, this could be the most important training that you attend this year. So make sure that you register through that link in the caption of this video, and you will be so glad you did.